Shapes up for an early cross. Austin Atieno! Goal to Kenya! Just like last Thursday, they are in the mood for another shake-up, another surprise. And that is the first goal that Zimbabwe have conceded in the 23rd edition of the COSAFA Cup. They lacked a little something in the final third. Well, in the second half, Atieno has provided quite a sumptuous finish. To deal with that Zimbabwean attacking threat. Benson Ochieng. Ochieng is through on goal. That's number two for Kenya. That's the goal that might send them through to the COSAFA Cup semi-finals for the very first time in their history. It is a massive goal. One that started all the way back in the hands of Amondi. And then resilient running from Benson Ochieng to cause all kinds of chaos at the back for Zimbabwe. Oh, it looks like Benson Ochieng did get the meaningful and final touch. Just got there ahead of Muriwa, who I was just praising for being so composed. Not that occasion.
We had a very difficult first half because of the wind. The wind was going against us, so we were finding it tough to pass the through balls to our striker. Then coming into second half, we knew the wind is going on our side, so we had to push so that we can get the two goals. On the first half, we knew that the defense is stepping up high, so we came on second half trying to put the balls behind them. Yeah, so we saw the first half how it was, so we second half we came to give the long balls to, behind them, so we managed to get a goal through it. Honestly, we did not expect that. We were so disappointed on the first half, but we came up on the second half with more effort. That really helped us. Yeah.
Congratulations, Austin.
Thank you, thank you.
I think, first of all, let me commend my boys. They did a good job, despite the condition. It was too windy. It was not easy to play football. And then the other thing was the first half, we knew, like, if you can contain them, because of this side, the wind was blowing a lot. So we knew in the second half we'll hit them because they were not very good in defending high balls. So that is, we capitalized on that one. We were hitting the high balls and then coming for the second ball, and then we punished them. I think we were not stringing, our passes were not done well. And then the other thing, we lacked a leader. In the first half, we were like, everybody was quiet. And then we had a chat in the, at a halftime, and then we told them, we need to have to be leaders, all of us. We need to talk, and then it should be positive talk, not just talking. So that, is, I think, is the other thing that worked for us in the second half. I think if these guys are young, so they need to be like pushed up to the end. They are not like the professionals who you just sit and then let them do the job because you've done your work in training. But these ones, we had to push them, and that it worked at the end of the day. I think the first thing, when we came into this tournament, it was just to try and unearth new talents who will graduate to the senior team. And at least I think I'm happy so far because we've seen some players performing well. And then in this tournament, the organization is superb. Everything is superb. There's nothing to complain about. And then we just ask them to make sure, like the next time, they increase the number of guys coming because we needed like 26 players or, and more officials.